The gentle lady yields back, and now we recognize the gentle lady from Texas, a ranking member on the Subcommittee on Oversight, Investigations and Regulations, Ms. Van Duyne, for 5 minutes.
Thank you very much, Chairwoman Velasquez. As this committee has heard countless times, access to capital is essential for small businesses. But I can't help but think that a lot of the initiatives that are being put forward by the Democrat Congress are detrimental to the goals of our nation's small businesses. And this includes raising small business income taxes, capping the small business deduction, and raising capital gains and estate taxes. All of this comes while small businesses still can't fill their labor needs and our supply chains remain disrupted. As we proceed with this hearing, it's important to underscore that it's not happening in a vacuum. There are very real harms Texas small businesses will face should the reconciliation package that Democrats are attempting to jam through become law. According to the Texas Public Policy Foundation, Texas businesses will lose $663 billion in investments. Corporate tax hikes will cut wage growth by over 23% for employees. And international tax cuts will reduce full-time employment by 12,000 jobs. This is nothing of the $12,000 reduction in median family income or the exploding debt the average household will be expected to cover because of federal spending. And finally, I want to reiterate how disappointing it is to watch Secretary Yellen skirt her legal obligations to come before this committee while small businesses in our community continue to fight to keep their doors open. I will continue to ask, but I really hope to see her before this committee very soon.